Hello, today we are starting a new series on HP LoadRunner. So this is the first video in that series, so let us get started. Now HP LoadRunner is an application performance testing solution from Hewlett-Packard. Basically it is a set of tools. LoadRunner is the leading performance testing toolset in the market. It is a proprietary tool, that means it is not open source. LoadRunner creates and manages virtual users, also called as VUsers. VUsers are nothing but software representation of real human users. So just like real human users, VUsers perform end user actions. Also, VUsers are independent of one another. LoadRunner takes performance measurements like response times, throughput, and concurrent VUsers. The good thing about LoadRunner is that it works with numerous protocols like Web, Flex, and so many more. A protocol is nothing but a communication procedure between the client and the server. LoadRunner is very user-friendly and has numerous useful features. Now, HP LoadRunner has some components which are the tools inside of the LoadRunner toolset. These are the virtual user generator, the controller, and the analysis. These tools work independently and also they can work together with one another. Now let us understand them one by one. So first we have the virtual user generator, also called as a VuGen. So using VuGen, we can record business processes like purchase an item on a website or pay a bill or book a hotel room online. VuGen generates automated performance testing script. So this automated performance testing script is called VUser script in LoadRunner. Using VuGen, we can add transactions. A transaction is a part of a VUser script. The purpose of a transaction is that it is used to measure the time it takes to complete one or more actions of a business process. Using VuGen, we can edit the performance testing script, like we can add think time. Think time is the pause before a VUser action, or we can use different test data. Now let us look at the second tool within LoadRunner, and this is the controller. Using controller, we can set up a performance test. For example, we can specify the load generators. Load generators are the computers that create and run VUsers that send requests to the system under test. Or we can specify the test duration. The settings of a performance load test is called a scenario in LoadRunner. The controller runs the performance test. And also using the controller, we can monitor the performance test as it is running. So we can see the different performance measurements. The third tool in LoadRunner is the analysis. Analysis collects and consolidates the test logs from all the load generators. Using analysis, we can view the performance test results. In analysis, we can analyze the performance test results by comparing the measurements taken by LoadRunner to our performance requirements, or we can review multiple graphs or even merge several graphs into one. Now let us look at the performance testing process that we use in LoadRunner. So the first step is to gather the performance requirements and plan the performance test. First of all, we need to gather the requirements like which business processes we need to test and what are the expected response times, what is the expected throughput, and the expected concurrent users. In planning the performance test, we need to identify the type of performance test to run. For example, it can be a load test or it can be an endurance test. We also need to identify the load generators which are going to send the requests to the server, and also identify the test environment which contains the system to be tested. The second step in the performance testing process is to create the VUser scripts, and this is done in VuGen. We record or create the automated performance testing script in VuGen. Also, we create sufficient and realistic test data to be used in the performance test. The third step in the process is to set up the scenario in the controller. That means we can set up the performance test settings within the controller. Once the scenario is set up, we can run the scenario in the controller. So we run and monitor the performance test in the controller. If needed, we may need to adjust the scenario and run it again until we get consistent test results. So it is not a one-time test like in functional testing. In performance testing, we may need to run the scenario multiple times until we achieve consistent test results. The last step in the process is to analyze the results in analysis. We view the performance test results in analysis and compare them to our performance requirements. This helps us determine if the system under test satisfied our performance requirements or not. Now let us see how we can download HP LoadRunner. So this is the URL. So if you go to this URL, it comes to this page, which is the LoadRunner page. And here there is the option to try or buy LoadRunner. Now LoadRunner is available as a free download. So this is for your evaluation and training purpose. And it is also available to buy online. So we can click on the download now button. And once you download LoadRunner, you can get the LoadRunner executable. And you make sure that you are logged into your Windows computer as an administrator, and you double click on this file to run it. So this installs HP LoadRunner on the Windows computer. Once you have LoadRunner installed, so there will be a program group under HP software. And here we can see all the tools. For example, we have the virtual user generator, we have the controller, and we have the analysis. So this is all in this video. In the next video, we'll look at the sample application provided by HP LoadRunner and also see how we can create the VUser script. So thank you for attending this video, and see you in the next one.